Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on getting started with the badge component in a Blazor WebAssembly application. The badge is a CSS-based component that indicates a status or notification using different colors and shapes and is often used in the Messenger apps. In this video, I will show you how to create a Blazor WebAssembly application and add the badge component to it. You will see the different shapes and types of badges. I will also show you how to integrate the badge component with other UI components. Before proceeding, make sure that you have one of the following .NET SDKs and one of these IDEs installed in your machine. I open Visual Studio 2022 and select Create a New Project. From the list of project templates, I choose Blazor WebAssembly App and name the project. I proceed with the default target framework and click Create. The project has been created and is ready to use. If you want to learn more about Blazor WebAssembly apps and how to add Syncfusion components to them, click the video link shown in the YouTube card above. To add the Syncfusion badge component, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor notifications package. So, I open the NuGet package manager. In the Browse tab, I search for the Syncfusion Blazor Notifications package. And install it. Once the installation is completed, I open the project dependencies and check the packages section to make sure that Syncfusion Blazor Notifications is installed. I then navigate to the imports.razor page and add the Syncfusion Blazor Notifications namespace so that I can use the badge component in any of the components available in the pages folder. Next, I open the program.cs file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. I register the Syncfusion Blazor services by calling the addSyncfusionBlazor method. Then, I register a valid license key in my application using the registerLicense method. To see where to generate a trial license key, refer to the link in the description. To add CSS to the badge component, I need to install the Syncfusion themes package. So, navigating to the NuGet package manager, I search for Syncfusion Blazor themes and install it. Next, I open the index.html file and reference the CSS from the installed themes package. I also add the script reference manually to enable better loading performance of the app. Now, the application is ready to add the badge component. I open the index.razor page and remove the existing code. As I said already, the badge is a CSS-based component and it will be rendered when the appropriate CSS classes are added to the target element. To demonstrate, I am going to add the Syncfusion Blazor button component. For that, I install the Syncfusion Blazor buttons package. And reference the buttons namespace. I add the button component by defining the sfbutton tag and setting the button content to inbox. I want to add a badge to this button. So, I add a span tag with the content 99. To make this span tag a badge, I add a predefined class ebadge to it. This ebadge class will add some default CSS style attributes to the container element and render as a badge. I save the changes and run the application. you can see the button component is rendered with a badge. Here, the badge renders adjacent to the button text. To display it on the right top corner like a notification, I need to add the eBadge Overlap class. To demonstrate, I add the eBadge Overlap class to the span tag. For better alignment, I need to set the position relative for the target element. So, I add the class eButton to the button component. Within the style tag, I define the eButton class and set the position to relative. Notice the badge renders on the right top corner as a notification now. Here, the background color of the badge is set according to the theme. You can customize the background color and font styles of the badge by adding appropriate CSS classes. There are 8 predefined colors supported by the badge component for various scenarios like success, danger, warning, info, and so on. To display the badge with the primary indication, I add the class eBadgePrimary. Checking now, the badge is displayed with the primary indication and the background color is changed. By default, the badge displays in a rectangular shape. It can also be displayed as a circle or dot notification. To display it as a circle, I add the eBadge Circle CSS class to the span tag. You can see the badge is displayed in a circle shape. The default position of the badge notification is the top. I can also display it at the bottom by adding the eBadge Bottom class. To demonstrate, I add the eBadge Bottom class to the span tag. As I am going to display the notification at the bottom, I would like to display it as a dot notification. So, I replace the eBadge Circle class with the eBadge Dot class. Look here, the dot notification is displayed at the bottom. Next, let's see how to integrate the badge component with other UI components like list view, toolbar, and accordion. In this example, I'll show you how to integrate the badge component with the Blazor toolbar component. First, I install the Syncfusion Blazor Navigations package. And reference the Syncfusion Blazor Navigations namespace. Then, I add the toolbar component by pasting the code snippet from the existing demo application. If you want to know more about this demo application, refer to the Syncfusion Blazor demo page attached in the description below. Here, in this toolbar, I have added the toolbar items of a Messenger app, where I have menu options, new inbox messages, friend requests, and favorite messages. And I have used appropriate icons for these toolbar items using the appropriate CSS classes. Now, I am going to add notifications for these toolbar items. I first add a span tag for the inbox item and then add the class eBadge. As I want to set the number of new messages as a primary notification, I add the classes eBadgePrimary and eBadgeNotification. I also want to keep the notification on the right top corner of the inbox icon, so I add the class eBadgeOverlap. I set the number of new messages to 35. I add notifications for friend requests and favorite messages the same way, by adding the span tags with appropriate badge classes. I also place this toolbar inside a division element. And add the classes ContainerDiv and BadgeToolbar to align the toolbar. Then I define those classes inside the style tag and add the appropriate CSS styles like margin, padding, display, and overflow. Looking now, the badge component is integrated with the toolbar. In this video, we have seen how to create a Blazor WebAssembly application and add the Blazor badge component to it. We have seen different types and shapes of the badge component. We have also seen how to integrate the badge component with other UI components. If you want to see a working example of this content, download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.